Hello children, welcome to online session. Today we are going to learn about adaptation, how animals survive. This is your fifth unit of science. In this lesson, we will discuss about adaptation and habitats of the animal. First, I have given the definition of adaptations and habitats. What is the meaning of adaptations? The process of changing to suit the surroundings is called adaptation. Habitats, the natural place where an animal lives is called its habitats. The natural place where an animal lives is called habitat, I told. Animals can be placed under this five major groups according to their habitat. There are five categories of the place. What are the places? Listen, first one, animals that live on land, animals that live in water, animals that live both on land and in water, animals that live on trees, animals that fly. So, all the animals can be placed under these five groups according to their habitat. Now, we will discuss one by one place. In that first place, animals that live on land. Okay, for that one more name is there, it is called terrestrial animal. Animals that live on land is called terrestrial animal. Here I have displayed some terrestrial animal picture. Hen, dog, cow, ant, snake and lion, etc. So many animals will be living on the land. So animals that live on land is called terrestrial animal. Usually they have well developed sense organs, especially dog. Dog is well developed sensor organ. Next, they breathe with the help of the lungs like human beings. They have legs which help them to run fast. This is the way to escape from enemies, and also they catch their prey. All the animals having sharp and claws and teeth. I'm telling about only terrestrial animal. Terrestrial animal, usually they have sharp claws and teeth. Especially cow, horse, goat, etc. Some terrestrial animals found near our home like dog and cat. Some terrestrial animal will be in the zoo. Children, in this slide, we are going to discuss about land areas. Let us study about two land areas having opposite feature, desert and polar animals. Desert animal and polar animals. These animals will come under the terrestrial animal category. Children, in this slide, we are going to discuss about desert animal. Look at this picture. Camel. First picture is camel. Second one is desert rat. And third picture is scorpion. Okay. Desert are very hot place during the day and it will be very cold in night. There is very little water and food. Animals which is living in the desert, they need to protect themselves from the heat and cold. They survive on less food and water. They conserve water in their body. Okay, listen here. This is a camel. We will call the sheep of the desert. Okay, this camel lives in desert. It can survive without food and water for many days. The camel can drink large quantities of water at one time. The hump is, you know, see, this is the hump The hump on its back stores fat. It gives the energy. See, this is called hump. So this hump gives energy to the camel when it is unable to find the food. The camel has a thick skin. It gives protection from heat and cold. A camel also has padded feet to move on hot sand place. See, here this is very padded feet. So because of that only it is moving in the hot sand area. They do not sink in the sand. The padded feet also protect the camel from hot sand. Most of the desert animals are very small size. It is very hot during the day. So some birds and reptiles are active only during the dawn and dusk. Many animals such as the desert rat restrict all their activity to the cooler temperature of the night. They sleep in a cool den, cave or burrow during the day. Next, we will discuss about the polar areas. The poles are covered with the snow throughout the year. See, look at this. This is the pole. It's covered with snow throughout the year. They are the coldest places on earth. Food is also scarce. Animals living here, they need to store food in their body. They protect themselves from the cold. The body stores food as thick layer of fat. This makes the animals look big. See children, in the desert, hot and cold, both it will be, but in polar region, only cold will be. So the animal which is living in the polar area, they have to store the food in their body and it's protect themselves from the cold. Look at this picture. This is called polar bear. Observe the size of its body. This body stores food as thick layer of fat. So this makes the animal looking like big. Okay, and here it is called penguin. Penguin also store fat in their body. They sit close to each other to keep themselves warm. See how it is sitting? All the penguins are sitting closely to each other because to give the warm, to keep themselves warm. Now, in this slide, we are going to discuss about animals that live on water. There is another name is called aquatic animal. Animals that live in water are called aquatic animal. Here I have displayed some picture. See what are the aquatic animal? Crab, crocodile, tortoise, octopus, snake, blue whale, sea horse, dolphin, sea turtle. So these are called aquatic animal. They move very easily through the water. Aquatic animals need special structure to prevent water from being absorbed into their body. They will move easily through the water. They will breathe in the water. Mostly aquatic animals spend their entire life in water. Their skin will not get affected because the body of aquatic animals are adapted for staying under water. You just imagine fish. Fish is unique shape and it is helping it to move easily in water. The fins help it to swim and balance itself in water. Some aquatic animals like whales and dolphins do not have gills. They have lungs to breathe. So that type of aquatic animal come up to the surface of water to breathe fresh air. Some water birds have webbed feet like duck or paddle like flippers as in turtle. Now third category, animals live both on land and water. animals that live both on water and land, it is called amphibians. Okay, in water their skin absorbs oxygen from the water and it will help them to breathe. Here I have displayed some amphibians picture. See which are the amphibians: snake, then tortoise, frog, crocodile. See, these animals will be living on the land as well as water. These animals have fold of their skin between the fingers of their feet. They are called webs. These webs help the animals to swim. When on land, amphibians breathe with their lungs. In water, their skin absorbs oxygen from the water and help them to breathe. Fourth category, animals that live on trees. Animals that live on trees are also called arboreal animal. Arboreal animal, see, this is the image of animals which is living on the trees. These animals mostly spend time on the trees. They have strong arms. See, they have strong arms and legs to climb the trees. They can also hold on the branches with their strong claws. They can also hold on to branches with their strong claws. Squirrel, longer, monkeys, tree lizard. See, this is a tree lizard picture. So these are the some examples of arboreal animals. Some type of monkeys have a very long tail. They use it as a fifth limb to hold on to the branches while swinging from the tree to tree. Children, this is the last category. Animals that fly. Animals that fly is called aerial animal. They have unique body structure, such as wings, body feathers, light and hollow bones. These hollow bones make their body light and help them to fly. Their tail help the direction changing while flying. Okay, all the birds having feathers on their body because these feathers will help them to keep the warm. See, this is the bat. Bat is not a bird, but bat is a mammal. Bat do not have any feathers on its wings. The wings are made up of thin layer of skin. These are stretched across the arms and fingers like an umbrella. It is also has very long fingers. These help the bat while flying. Children, we are going to discuss about adaptation for the food. All the animals like us need food to survive and be healthy. Different kinds of animals eat different kinds of food. Let's know about the eating habits of animal. Already you know there are three types of animal. See, first picture shows carnivorous animal. Carnivorous animal will eat only meat and flesh. They have very sharp front teeth which help them to cut the meat. Next, herbivorous animal. Animals which is eating only plant is called herbivorous animal. Okay, this kinds of animals will be having flat type of teeth. It will be using for grinding, and at the back of their mouth help them to chew the grass. Next, third category, omnivorous. Okay, animals which is eating both plants and other animal flesh is called omnivorous animal. For example, human being. We are the omnivorous category. Dog, bear. These are called omnivorous animals. Apart from that, some animals depend on other living animals for food. They are called parasites. Mosquitoes, leeches, and flies. They have a sucking tube in their mouth. With the help of this, they suck the blood of the other animal. So these are called parasites. Children, next we will learn about adaptation for the protection. Like us, animals too live in their home. Homes protect them from the heat. All the animals defend themselves from their enemies. For example, some animals run very fast to escape from their enemies, like deer and kangaroos. Rhinoceros and buffaloes, they have horns for defense. Tortoise and snail have a hard shell. When they faced any danger, they go into the shell. Zebras and tiger have strip on their body. So this strip make them difficult to spot in the jungle. And one more last point, cuttlefish. This cuttlefish has an ink sac on its body. When it senses danger, it will release the ink. So this ink will make the enemy to confuse. Finally, it will making the water blue. Children, this is the last topic, adaptation and behavior. In this topic, very important point is migration. What is the meaning of migration I have given? Animals living in very cold places travel to warmer places in winter for searching food. It is called migration. Okay, animals that live in very cold place find it difficult to survive in winter. It gets very cold and there is shortage of food. So they leave their homes and travel to warmer places. When winter ends, they travel back home. This is called the migration. Birds like storks, Siberian cranes and mallard ducks, they come to India every winter. When winter is over, they return to their native places. Some animals like deer also travel several kilometers in search for the food. They travel in herds. What is the meaning of herds? Group of deer is called herds. Even snakes also will be migrating. Some snake and frogs cannot survive in the cold winter animal. So they eat a lot of food during summer and they store the extra food in their body as fat. When winter comes, they sleep in caves or underground holes. This is called hibernation. What is the meaning of hibernation? I repeat. During summer, they eat lot of food. They will store the extra food on their body as fat. When winter comes, they sleep in caves or underground holes. This is called hibernation. These animals are able to survive on the extra fat stored in their body. Children, I hope you understood this lesson. Please take your textbook, go through the paragraph along with the PPT. Please learn all the lines one by one, make it to understand. If any doubt is there, you can clarify with the live class. I hope you understood this lesson. Thank you, children.